First and foremost, I want to give all honors and praises, bear with me just a minute, and glory belongs to my Lord and Savior, whose name is Yahawah, Bahashem, Yahawashi, Bahashem, Wahavakar Kodash. The name of the Heavenly Father is Yahawah. Okay, and his son's name is Yahawashi. In who I reverence and honors the elder apostles of great most, and those of you that are in the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of Yahawashi. Okay, not the spirit of this world. And to the hopeful elect across the globe, and to the few, the very few brothers and sisters listening and also learning in the hopes of being saved within these last days. Because these are the last days of the last days. These are the days to what seek closer there unto Yahawah Yahawashi. Right? And a man of the Lord, he ain't gonna let outward circumstances stop him from teaching his truth. Right? So we're gonna start from Timothy. The Lord is in the edifying. Okay. So that 1 Timothy 1 and 7, for the Most High has not given us the spirit of fear, right? Because fear, what does it create? Torment. You can't move, you're stuck. Okay? But of power and of love. So there's power through these words and love. Through having faith, there's power within that. And there's also what? Love. Because faith, when you have faith, it also shows you have love. Because you're going to be charitable. You're not going to be putting yourself first. But of power and love and of a sound mind, and you have a sound mind by teaching the right thing, not by getting together with another group of individuals that are not teaching the same thing. You don't have a sound mind like that by teaching away with doctrine. Okay? Be not therefore ashamed of the testimony of our Lord Yahawashi. You can't be ashamed to profess this word. You can't be teaching this word, but you have your face covered, you have your hood on, you don't want anybody to see you. That's someone that's ashamed. See? Bear with me. Someone that's of this world, never gonna be ashamed. Excuse me. See, the people of this world, they're ashamed, right? When you've got men in the truth, they're ashamed to what? To preach this word. They care about what their woman thinks, their mother thinks, the world thinks. A clear separation is being made. Those that are for Yahawashi and those that are not for Yahawashi. That clear separation is being made, right? Be not ashamed of the testimony, the witness of Yahawashi. And only a few have his testimony, because they were with him back then. The elect were with Yahawashi back then. So they were going to have his testimony, the true testimony. Right? Not the testimony of the world. Right? Excuse me. They're going to have testimony of Yahawashi, not the world, right? Not what they were doing in the world, of Yahawashi, of what Yahawashi was doing. Who did he come for, right? All these different things. So yes, not everybody that's teaching this word has the testimony of Yahawashi. Only a few men, right? That are making him necessary sacrifices for this truth, right? Bear me just a minute, I'm just trying to straighten this out. But again, this is a part of the battle. This is a major part of the battle, right? So only a few have that testimony of the Lord, nor me of his prisoner, Paul, but be thou partaker of the afflictions of the gospel according to the power of the Most High. So you're sharing that suffering, the same suffering Yahawashi went through. You're sharing it. You're being a partaker, right? The rest of the world, they're not partakers of the suffering of Yahawashi. That's where they're gonna die. Okay? Of the gospel according to the power of the Most High, who have saved us through his hopeful elect and called us with a holy calling. Yeah, this is a holy calling, right? This is not suffering of the world, you know? This is definitely not suffering of the world. Oh, come join our camp. Yeah, you're of the elect because you're part of our camp. That's not a holy calling. That's a calling of the world, right? You would have to be called from the foundation, right? A holy calling from directly from Yahawashi, not of men, right? Because you could be called into a camp, but you could still be what? Wicked. Not really put off the old man, okay? Just be a complete demon, okay? Not according to our works. So it's not even according to the work that we're doing. It was according to the election, right? It was nothing that we were doing. It just so happened to be you were one of them, what? Them special spirits that were called to what? To make it. Lord Ratazah. But according to his own purpose, this is all according Yahawashi's purpose, not our own purpose. A man can't will himself, because most of us, we never knew what we were going to be doing. Okay, 6, 7, 10 years, we never knew. But Yahawashi had it where certain of his men, they were going to be serving Yahawashi, and it wasn't going to be a weekly thing. It wasn't going to be a week, a monthly thing. It was going to be daily, right? And you were not going to be dragging yourself. He was going to select men that actually did want to get out of here. They were not half-time, part-time Israelites. They were full-time, right? But according to his own purpose and grace, mercy, which was given us by Yahawashi Mashiach, before the world began, because what, you always had a remnant that were with Yahawashi. Okay, but it's now made manifest by the appearing of our Savior Yahawashi Mashiach, who have abolished death through his sacrifice and have brought life and immortality to light through the gospel. So now we're going to go to John. Okay, John 17, these words spake Yahawashi and lifted up. Okay, bear me just a minute. Okay, and lifted up his eyes to heaven. All right. And said, Father, the hour is come. Glorify thy son. So Yahawashi was glorified after that crucifixion, right? So right now, us in this truth, We're not going to be glorified now. The glory comes after suffering. A lot of men, they want the glory now. Okay? The glory comes after that suffering. Bear me just a minute. That's when the glory comes, after you've suffered, right? That's when we get the glory. But right now, it's suffering. Then you have the glory, not the other way around. Okay? A lot of men want the glory, but they don't want to suffer. Okay? That thy son also may glorify thee. So Yahawashi, when he was upon earth, what was his whole duty? His duty was to glorify the heavenly Father Yahweh. So what's our duty? It's to glorify Yahawashi and his word. Not to glorify in camps. I'm in this camp. That doesn't matter. It don't matter. Because Yahawashi is looking at the men individually. Okay? You've seen men that come in, come out of camps, but they were never really sincere. They never had the right mindset towards Yahawashi. Okay? And thou hast given him power over all flesh, but he should give eternal life to as many as thou hast given him. So Yahawashi has given eternal life, everlasting life, to those that believe in him. Right? To as many that has given him, because his elect, they were given to Yahawashi by the Heavenly Father. They were handpicked, particular men were handpicked to be given to Yahawashi. They could be presented as a sacrifice to Yahawashi. Just how Yahawashi was a sacrifice to the Heavenly Father. But we are sacrifices to Yahawashi, same thing. Okay? And this life eternal, that they might know thee, the only true power, and Yahawashi, whom thou hast sent. So the elect, they know the Heavenly Father, and they know Yahawashi. Right? I have glorified thee on the earth. I have finished the work which thou gavest me to do. So Yahawashi, he finished. Yahawashi, he never stopped. He never stopped within his ministry. He continued. So that shows we can't stop. We have to continue. Right? It's not about us. It's about Yahawashi. Right? And it says, thine they were. Thou gavest them. Wait just a minute. I have manifested thy name unto the men which thou gavest me out of the world, right? So they were also going to know, yes, the name. They were going to know the name, right? Thine they were, and thou gavest them me, and I've kept thy word. So the elect, they were going to keep this word. And the scripture says, hold fast, and let no man take thy crown. So what are we going to do? Hold fast unto this truth. Right? And don't let anybody take your crown. Anyone. That's what the elect were going to be doing. Hold fast, holding tight. Right? They were not going to be going right back into the world and being lackadaisical. Right? Dragging themselves, not really wanting to be here. This was going to be their life. Why? Because they lived this. They were not actors. They were not stage actors. Right? They believed. Okay? A lot of men want rank, but they don't want to deal with the responsibility that comes with rank, right? It doesn't matter how long you've been in. You could be in for 10 years, but still be carnal. Okay? You could be in for 2-3 years, and still be over that man that's been in for 10 years. Right? Why? Because you endured. You were growing. Okay? Even what was said to Jeremiah, fear them not, I will put these words in thy mouth. Right? So you can't have the mentality, you've just been in this truth for, you know, a little while. The scripture says, you're not supposed to lay a stumbling block. So if you see something, you say it, you address it. You don't ignore it, okay? Why? Because that's what the hopeful elect are gonna do, right? They were not gonna shy away, because that's not a leader. You just see wickedness going on, and you don't say anything. Well, you're not a true leader. You're a coward. You're following a multitude to do evil. So therefore, you're gonna be destroyed with a multitude. That's why you have to have, Yahawashi gives you your own mind. Obviously, you're operating in the words of Yahawashi, but it gives you your own mind to make what? The right decisions. A lot of men, they can't make the right decisions, right? Because they haven't learned, they haven't grown, right? They put their trust in men rather than their trust in Yahawashi, right? Yahawashi is looking for men that, yeah, they have other men around him, but they're able to make decisions. Why? Because that's what men do. Men make hard decisions when nobody else is able to make them decisions, right? That's called being what? Spiritual and not carnal. Okay? And it says, now they have known all the things whatsoever that's given me of thee, right? Which is what is truth. Okay? For I have given them unto them thy words, which thou gavest me. So the elect, they have these words. They have these promises, right? They have that foundation. Okay? Bear me just a minute. They have that foundation. All right? And they have received them, right? With what? A good mind. Okay? They weren't ifing and butting and guessing. Oh, is this really the truth? Okay? No, they were given the word and they were sure of what they were taught. Right? And it says, which thou gavest me, they have received them and they have surely known. Right? But I came out from thee. Right? And they have believed that they did send me, so they believed in the record of Yahawashi. They also had the record. So they had a strong foundation. The hopeful elect, they have a strong foundation. Why? Because they believe in the record. Right? Of Yahawashi, that he is the son of the Most High. Okay? All these things are important. You have to believe in the record. Right? And it says, bear me just a minute. I pray for them. So it says them, right? A select few within the nation, them. So that's very particular. So Yahawashi is praying for his men. Yahawashi is praying for those that belong to him, right? I pray for them. Didn't say the whole world. I pray for them. Okay. I pray for them. I pray not for the world. So it wasn't the whole world. Right? For them. Did the hopeful elect. Okay. So even within the world of Israel, Yahweh ain't praying for all of our people. Only those that are doing his will. Okay? I pray for them. I pray not for the world, but for them which has given me, for they are dying. So it's for those that the Heavenly Father Yahweh has given Yahawashi. A remnant, they'll be known as the first fruits. Okay? And now I am no more in the world, Yahawashi. I'm moving too fast, verse 10. All mine are thine. Right? All that Yahawashi has been given are thine, the Heavenly Father's, and vice versa. And thine are mine, and I am glorified in them. So What does it mean he's glorified in them? Why? Because we glorify Yahawashi. So Yahawashi is glorified within us. Why? Because we glorify his name. Right? We don't glorify ourselves. We glorify the words of Yahawashi. Right? It's not about us. Okay. And it says, I am glorified in them, now I'm no more in the world. But these are in the world, so yeah, we're still in the world. Okay, because a man would use this and say, see, but the scripture says in John 17, we're still in the world. So a man that's carnal, he would use that to justify his position of going back into the world and having seven other demons upon him. No. What does it mean that they are in the world? They're in the world because they need to what? They have a job to do. They have to minister. That's our whole purpose. Okay. We're only here to visit. Okay, to bring this word out. And that's it. Okay. That the elect may be sealed. And come unto thee, a holy father. Keep true thy own name. Those whom thou hast given me, that they may be one as we are. Though that may be one, so the elect, they were also going to be one. But what were they going to be one in? The doctrine, what they were taught. That's what they were going to be one in. One thought. They were not going to be gathering up or linking up with other men that had different doctrines, different demons in their mind. They were going to be of one mind, right? One faith, right? And it says, while I was with them in the world, I kept them in thy name. So while Yahawashi was with the disciples, he kept them in thy name, in the Heavenly Father's name. Right? Because remember, Yahawashi was building up the disciples. So when he left, they would be strong. Okay? And it says, bear me just a minute. I've kept them in thy name, those that gave us me, I've kept. And none of them is lost, right? None of them is lost to the truth. But the son of perdition, of what? Destruction. Right? The scripture might be fulfilled. Who's that speaking of? That's speaking of that scumbag, Judas Iscariot, right? And Judas Iscariot, guess what? Judas Iscariot, he was a devil, right? Judas Iscariot, he had a deceitful spirit upon him. And he was also covetous. He was all about what? The treasury, right? And he was replaced. That was the spirit of Judas Iscariot. Judas Iscariot wasn't a man that's... So, Judas Iscariot wasn't the spirit of a man that's no longer in a camp. Judas Iscariot was covetous and he never really believed. And he was carnal. That's why you got to look out for men that are of the world and that are covetous. So yeah, the signs are there. But his brothers, they need to be more spiritual. Okay? So he was lost and he hung himself because he betrayed the Lord, Yahawashi. Right? He was a devil. You got men saying, oh, Yahawashi never mentioned Judas until he was betrayed. Yes, he did. Several times. He let him know that he wasn't right, several times. Didn't, when he was washing the disciples' feet, didn't he wash Judas's feet? And he said, some of you are here, but some of you are not clean. So who was he speaking of? He was speaking of Judas. He mentioned Judas several times, said, and there's some of you that are here that believe not. So he addressed him several times. And them same spirits are back here today, claiming to be in the truth, but they're not in the truth. They're in the world, they're of the world. That's why you got to be able to differentiate who's really in the truth and who's not. Because you may be standing next to an individual, he doesn't really give a shit. He was persecuting Yahawashi 2,000 years ago, but you're standing up there with him, smiling in his face. Right? And now come I to thee, these things I speak to the world, that they might have my joy fulfilled in themselves. So guess what? The elect, they have this joy fulfilled within themselves. The joy of this gospel, the joy of salvation, they have this fulfilled in themselves. Because if you don't have this, you're not going to be fulfilled. You're going to be seeking the world. Okay? And I have given him thy words, and the world have hated them. Okay? The world have hated them. See, it says there's a clear separation that's being made. So the hopeful elect, it says the world have hated them. So guess what? If you're of the world, you're going to be hating the hopeful elect. The world have hated them. So yeah, the prophets, the true prophets, they were hated by the majority. Because the scripture said that would happen. They will not be loved. Shalom, great video. Every video you post, great video. 8 views. You could be lukewarm as hell. You could be wicked as hell. You could be slothful. Shalom, 19 likes. Nope, doesn't add up. That's because you're of the world. You cater to the world, right? So you gotta be able to differentiate, okay? Who's for the truth and who's not? Because they are not of the world. Even as I'm not of the world. That's why they hate it. Because they are not of the world. Even as Yahawashi was not of the world. Right? When Yahawashi was here, he was on the higher wavelength. That's why the Pharisees, they were offended at him. The Sadducees, they were offended at him. Because he was on a whole nother wavelength. Right? He was in the world, but he was not of the world. Everything he was speaking was what? Heavenly. And it went over a lot of people's heads. Right? The majority of the Jews, they tried to take him out. They didn't like what he had to say. Why? Because they were of the world. Right? They were of this current setup. Okay? So they were hated. Okay? Because they are not of the world, even as I am not of the world. And you know what's so spiritual? Bear me just a minute. You know what's so spiritual? Let's go to John. And I think it's 11. Right? Let's go to John. 11. Bear me just a minute. This is John 11. This is when Yahawashi done the healing. So these individuals that I'm mentioning now, they were not in the truth. They were of the world. Okay? And it says, that many of the Jews which came to Mary had seen the things which Yahawashi did, believed on him. But some of them went their ways to the Pharisees and told them the things that Yahawashi had done. Then gathered the chief priests and Pharisees a council and said, what do we, for he did many miracles. If we let him thus alone, all men will believe on him. And the Romans shall come and take away both our place and nation. So these individuals, they were the ones that were doing the hating. Because it says they shall come and take away both our place and nation. So when we're going into these scriptures, you have to know, well, who's in the stead of the Pharisees and who's in the stead of those that are actually being hated, right? You have to know. Okay. Let's go to John 17. Doesn't fit the Pharisees. That doesn't fit the Pharisees because they were trying to uphold their position. So they were the ones that were doing the hating, right? It only makes sense, right? Because they were of the world. Their setup was of the world. Right? Oh, yeah. Right. Yeah. Right. Okay. Preaching the gospel. Okay. So their common setup, the Pharisees, it was of the world. It was not of Yahawashi. Right? That's why they were trying to say, if all men will believe on him, they shall come and take away both our places and nation. Why? Because Yahawashi was doing miracles. So that was destroying the structure of this kingdom, the Roman Empire, who the Pharisees were under. So it's the same thing today. And those that have the true testimony of Yahawashi, who they ignorantly call Jesus, they're going to be what? Isolated and slandered by the world, because the world accepts the world. If you're wicked, this world will accept you with open arms. If you're righteous, this world ain't going to accept you. Only a few are going to be down, right? And that's that separation. So yeah, if you're highly accepted by this world, it's because you're wicked. The scripture says, when a man's ways are pleasing to the Lord Yahweh Yahawashi, he causes his enemies to be at peace with him. That's something else. That's because your ways are pleasing, right? Because you could be hated for righteousness and you could be hated for wickedness. The elect, they're hated because they have the testimony of Yahawashi, right? And it says, we're still on John 17. And let's go straight to 17. Sanctify them through thy truth. Cleanse them, right? Thy word is truth. So this word that we're teaching, this is the truth. So that's how the hopeful elect are being cleansed, through this word. As thou sent me into the world, even so I have sent them into the world. Into the world. For what? To preach his gospel, to preach Yahawashi. Right? And the coming of what? A new kingdom. And for their sakes, I sanctify myself, that they also might be sanctified through the truth. So the elect, they're sanctified, they're made holy. And sanctified also means separate. So the elect, they're separate from this world, even from certain men in the truth. And that's why the Lord's going to let, Yahawashi's going to let you know if you are teaching with other men in this truth. If you're not supposed to be there, Yahawashi will get you out of there. All right? And don't let anybody tell you, well, oh, he walked out of the camp. No, ultimately, it's Yahawashi that got him out of there. For good reasons. It's not always a bad reason, right? Because most of the hopeful elect, some of them are not going to be in camps, right? See, that's the doctrine of the Pharisees. You have to be a part of my camp to make it, right? That's the doctrine of the Pharisees, right? The doctrine of men. The scriptures don't say that. You have to be a part of a congregation to make it. And the scriptures talk about a congregation of the wicked. Alright, bear me just a minute. The Lord Yahawashi is making that separation through this word. Let's quickly go to, bear me just a minute. Alright, let's quickly go to Psalms 1. Blessed is the man, okay, and the blessing is an increasement, that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly. So a council is what? A body of men, a congregation. Scripture's blessed. So Yahawashi can separate men from an ungodly congregation. A congregation of what? Idolatrous. Right? Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly. Right? Nor standing in the way of sinners. Right? So Yahawashi, he's not going to have a member elect just surrounded by men that are not really about the truth. He's going to protect them. Right? Nor sitteth in the seat of scornful men. Men that are scornful, men that don't even believe in the truth. Yahawashi ain't going to have you dwelling amongst them. He's going to get you away from them. So you could be what? Fully focused on him. Right? But his delight is in the law, right, of the Lord Yahawashi, the precepts, and his law that we meditate day and night. That's what the hopeful elect are going to be doing, meditating upon his law day and night. And he shall be planted like a tree planted by the rivers of water. And when a tree is planted by rivers of living water, it flourishes. That man's going to flourish, right? in his wisdom and his understanding, in his growth, right? See, separation is also elevation, right? Separation is also elevation. The Lord deals with separation, with everything, right? A lot of men, they don't even know what it's like to be by themselves and teach alone, okay? So what's gonna happen when all hell breaks loose? Are you still gonna be strong? So all these things are very, very fundamental for the times we're approaching, right? Because you're not always gonna, some of you are not gonna have, you may not have another brother beside you when Jacob's trouble breaks loose. So this is why it really counts now. What you're doing now, it counts now. What you do now, okay? And it says that bringing forth his fruit in due in season, right? So if you're planted by what? A river that's planted, a tree that's planted on river, it's going to be what? Bringing fruit. All kinds of good fruit. Flourishing, right? Increasing. All right? His leaf also shall not wither. In other words, you're not going to perish. The leaf ain't going to wither. Okay? You're gonna succeed in your works. You're not gonna perish, you're not gonna die, you're not gonna fade away, you're gonna bloom, you're gonna flourish. Right? And whatsoever he does shall prosper. So you're gonna have certain men, they're just gonna continue to prosper in this truth. Right? To flourish. Okay? But the ungodly are not so, but are like the chaff which the wind driveth away. So the ungodly, they're gonna be what? As chaff. Okay, the residue, scriptures tell you that in Corinthians, which the wind driveth away. Chaff is what? The residue of something, right? So if you're chaff, you're not gonna last. And the chaff is what? The residue of a particular thing. What's left over, right? Bear me just a minute, this is the ungodly are gonna be the chaff. Bear me just a minute. Okay, and it says, therefore the ungodly shall not stand in the judgment, nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous, because the righteous are being made separate. The righteous are going to be judged righteous. The wicked are going to be judged wicked. That's why you got to be careful who you're amongst. Okay, bear me just a minute. That's why you got to be careful who you're amongst, right? Does this man really believe, right? Because you examine certain things and it's like, hold on a minute, this guy, he was on the whole tirade, a scoffing spree for all these years. You look at this man's page, he never really believed. This guy was just being sarcastic, everything was a joke. So a man like that, who knows, he may repent. But if you've been like that for 4 or 5 years, everything's just a joke, then more likely you're going to just die, right? Lord's looking for the hopeful that are sincere, that are going to lay down their life for Yahawashi. Okay? Verse 6, for the Lord Yahawashi knoweth the way of the righteous. He already knows. The way is the path. He knows the path of the righteous. It's already been set out. It's already been written. Right? And everybody's just playing it out. But the way of the ungodly shall perish. What, like chaff? Bear me just a minute. Bear me just a minute. Excuse me, right? You gotta get to the point where you're ready focused. Everything else don't matter, right? Everything else is secondary. This is 1 Corinthians 3 and 6. I have planted, right? So we plant the word, okay? And Apollos watered, Apollos was a minister, right? Apollos was a minister of what? Paul, a helper, right? That was born in what? I believe it's Alexandria. Okay. And it says, Apollos watered, but the Most High gave the increase. So it's Yahawashi that increases a man in any understanding, knowledge he has. It's Yahawashi that increases that man, that builds him up.